Hey guys, in this video I'm going to do another proof from linear algebra. This proof says let n be a natural number and A be an n by n skew-symmetric matrix. Prove that if n is odd, then the determinant of A is equal to 0. So this is a little bit similar to the last proof that I did in that you have to know some basic determinant properties, and again we have to know what a skew-symmetric matrix is. So some basic determinant properties that you're going to use for this proof are that the determinant of A is always equal to the transpose of A for any n by n matrix, and also that if you have any constant C A that you need to find the determinant for, that's always going to be C to the n times the determinant of A, where n is equal to the value of the size of the matrix. So if you have an n by n matrix, it's the value n from the size of the matrix. Okay, so we can go ahead and solve the proof. So since n is odd, we know that negative 1 to the n is going to equal negative 1 for all values of n, so for all n in n. Then we're going to use the definition of what skew-symmetric means for a matrix, which is that the transpose of a matrix is always going to be equal to negative 1 times the matrix, or the negative of the matrix. Then we can take the determinant of both sides, so that's going to give us the determinant of A transpose is equal to the determinant of negative A. Like we said in the beginning, the determinant of A transpose is always going to be equal to the determinant of A, which is what we want in our proof, so we're going to say the determinant of A is equal to the determinant of A transpose, which by the definition of skew-symmetric has to be equal to the determinant of negative A. We can think of this as negative 1 times A, so the determinant of negative 1 times A, and in turn that's going to be, and we know this from the determinant properties, negative 1 to the n times the determinant of A, and that's going to be equal to the determinant of A. And since we wrote at the top that negative 1 to the n is going to equal negative 1 for all n in this case, then we know that the determinant of A is equal to negative the determinant of A. And if we bring this to the same side, we're going to get 2 times the determinant of A is equal to 0. And if we divide by 2, we're going to get that the determinant of A is equal to 0 divided by 2, which is equal to 0. And we're done with this proof.